Oh my God.
What do you think?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, it's the new Magnum Cutterworm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We start the TV show with another big fish in Comedero Lake. Steve.
Yeah.
Welcome to the TV show.
Thank you.
Oh my God.
It's a fat fish, you know?
Fat fish.
It's not muy grande, but it's very fat.
Yeah. Hey, what do you think is spawning?
No.
No?
Mucho comida.
Comida.
Yeah.
A lot of food. Okay. Amigos, una vez más aquí en su programa Vámonos de Pesca. Estamos aquí en la presa Comedero otra vez con nuestro buen amigo Steve Parks. Steve, welcome.
Thank you. And welcome to Comedero.
Oh.
It's a wonderful lake, beautiful lake.
Y la prueba aquí está.
Yeah.
What do you think if I go to increase the TV show?
Yes.
And after this, you explain me what is the new product for the race tape.
Yes, I sure will.
Okay.
Yeah.
Vamos a liberar la lobina. ¿Y qué les parece si ya liberando esta, nos vamos a la entrada del programa? No se vayan, quédense con nosotros porque va a haber más lobinas de ese tamaño aquí en Vámonos de Pesca. Gracias por coincidir con nosotros y esperarnos a regresar de la entrada al programa, porque el día de hoy estamos nuevamente con un programa de lujo, un programa que pensamos que va a ser de grandes lobinas, como lo que ya ven ustedes en programas pasados, porque el día de hoy está Steve Parks con nosotros. Steve, what do you think about the Comedero Lake?
It's the best lake in the world. There's not a better big bass lake in the entire world.
Es correcto. Yeah. And Ron Speed Junior Adventures.
That's right.
Excellent service.
For sure.
For sure, yeah. But you have a surprise for the Mexican anglers, because every time you come to Mexico, you have a big surprise for the fishing industry.
Yes. Well, for sure, this year we're coming out with the new Magnum Cutterworm. The Cutterworm has been a very popular and a very good lure for striking and for all of our friends. And when they all said, hey, Big O, can we get a bigger one, a bigger Cutterworm? And I said, yeah. I said, I can make you the Magnum.
Okay.
And so now this is the Magnum Cutterworm, and it's about 7.5 inches. And it's a very thick worm, and it's a lot bigger profile. And so we came out with that this year to follow up with the regular Cutterworm that was so good.
Okay.
That everyone likes so much, and now we've got the Magnum.
Hey,
so we'll be fishing this today.
Bigo, what is the difference in this kind of tail, another ribbon tail in another in the market?
Well, this is a much faster tail. The Cutterworm has the rage tail flange right here.
Mm-hmm.
And see, it's a cutworm style, but it's got a super fast hyper tail.
Okay.
And so the tail kicks very fast, and it very slow retreat. It's barely moving, and the tail's sitting here vibrating. It's like swimming.
A lot of action.
Yes, a lot of action, a lot of vibration.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, today, I think what I would like to do is, I've been finding the fish like the half ounce.
Half ounce?
Yes, because the speed of the fall and the light, this type of weight, this particular weight, is seems to be much better than a lot of the other, than 3/4 or 3/8. They like the half ounce.
Mm-hmm. And the place for work with this kind of lures is in the humps. Right?
Yeah, humps. Well, anything. Yeah, you can fish humps, you can fish drops, you can fish brush. The great thing about a Cutterworm and that profile, it's perfect for flipping, for casting, for Carolina rig, for swimming, for rage rig, you know, just weightless hook.
Okay.
It's a very versatile worm. The Cutterworm is extremely versatile.
Excellent. I can see you have a different hook. Never see.
Yeah, this is a new hook.
New hook? Uh-huh. Which brand is it? Because I've never seen.
This is called Hammer Hook from Game Changer Lures.
Wow.
And what it is, it's a redesigned hook. It's designed different than any other hook out there. There's round bend hooks are good for some things. EWGs are good for some things.
Mm-hmm.
But the great thing about the Hammer Hook is it's designed to be the variety of all hooks put into one.
Mm-hmm.
This has a very straight point right here, which is like an ice pick.
Uh-huh.
And then on this area right here, it's formed similar to EWG, except the point is pointing outside the hook point up here for a reason.
Yeah.
And the reason is you notice how straight this worm is hooked? Well, you can see on the back, right there, it's T-exposed in the back. So when the fish bites, he pops loose here and it falls straight down. So it opens the gap of the hook.
It's more easy for penetrate the
Yes, and see, and just pull it straight up. T-exposed, done.
Excellent.
And see how perfectly straight it is.
Excellent.
Yeah.
I want to test it.
Yeah.
Well, I test it.
You can test it just fine, but Bass R is going to have these.
Yeah.
This year, after ICAST,
okay.
This year, it'll be launched. And the only place you can get it in all of Mexico,
okay.
Bass R.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I think you'll like the hook. And for sure, these baits will be out at ICAST.
After the ICAST.
Posible before.
Ok. Nada más teniéndolos con nosotros estos productos, ahorita los van a ver funcionar. Se los hacemos llegar a través de bazar.mx o a través de nuestros distribuidores alrededor de la República Mexicana. I want to try.
Let's go.
Ok. Bueno, ahorita lo que estamos haciendo, como pueden ver, estamos en agua abierta, pero con las unidades Lawrence, ahí lo pueden apreciar. Estamos viendo un hump, una isla que quedó hundida y tiene un montón de árboles y estamos viendo si las lobinas están adentro de los árboles o están fuera de los árboles. Para esto estoy utilizando una caña 7 pies y medio heavy, porque así me lo piden las lobinas de aquí de Comederos. Es de la serie Custom Pro de Lius y el carrete que estoy usando es un Custom en relación 8-3-1, ya se los habíamos explicado. Cuando ganchas la lobina es necesario meter la línea rápidamente al carrete para que la lobina no la dejes tomar decisiones. Entonces, ahorita vamos a seguir buscando la caída. Si no están alrededor de la caída, están arriba de los árboles comiendo las tilapias que ahí se concentran. Pero, pues obviamente esa información no la va a dar la lobina. Es por eso que es importantísimo que tengas unas buenas unidades, unos buenos electrónicos para que te ayuden a descifrar esto. En conclusión, los electrónicos o el sonar de la lancha pues son tus ojos ahí abajo del agua, porque diferente a otras actividades que se hacen al aire libre, nosotros no podemos ver lo que está ahí abajo, pero sí lo podemos hacer con las unidades Lawrence, que ahorita vas a ver cómo trabajan y vas a ver cómo... ahorita vamos a tratar de ayudarte a que las interpretes mucho mejor. Hey, I'm explaining for my friends the Lawrence you need is our eyes under the water.
Yes, for sure, because you can see there's nothing here for you to see with your eyes above the water. It's all below the water, and the most important thing is what's down there. And with these Lawrence that we have on all of the Ron Speed boats and on my boat and your boat, is the Lawrence unit, I think, is the best sonar in the world. And it's very simple to use. It's very simple to use, very simple to understand. And for sure, you can see everything you need to see down there with the new Lawrence, yes.
Okay, entonces no tardes en ordenar tu unidad Lawrence. Hoy por hoy están las unidades, las nuevos Hook 2, los Elite, ya son tecnologías que hace años costaban a lo mejor el doble de lo que cuestan hoy y se ponen el precio un poco más accesible. Y te recordamos que ahí en Bazar tenemos el servicio de instalación, así como la asesoría personalizada para que puedas adquirir tu unidad Lawrence y le saques el mayor provecho. Bueno, vamos a seguir tirando. A ver si encontramos lobinas grandes aquí en esta presa Comederos y hospedados en Ron Speed Junior Adventures. Fish.
Skinny.
Yeah. Because
it's a big head.
Yeah, it's a big head.
Very skinny.
Yeah, it's after the spawning.
Oh yeah. Yeah, after the spawning.
Está muy muy flaca esta lobina. Chéquela. Como tiene el estómago, son lobinas que ya en esta parte de la presa ya desovaron. Pero vean el tamaño de los hocicos. Es una lobina. Una lobina ya de edad adulta. Entonces. Así quedan después del desove y lo viene el proceso de recuperación y en unos meses ya vuelven a estar otra vez gordos.
In a couple months they are fat.
Yeah. Because they have a lot of tilapias.
Yeah.
Okay, vamos a dejarla ir. Y estamos encontrando un patrón de pesca ahora acá en las puntas donde venimos a pescar con Steve. Pero los voy a invitar a que se queden a ver estos comerciales. Ahorita regresamos, están en Vámonos de Pesca. Esta es la prueba de la voracidad de las lobinas de aquí de Comederos. Chequen, esta lobina estaba flotando y vean el tamaño de la tilapia que trae en el hocico. Es impresionante. Déjame ver si lo puedo ayudar, que se le quedó atorada ahí adentro. Esto acaba de pasar ahorita, la tilapia todavía está viva.
Ya, adiós tilapia.
Adiós tilapia, maybe the fish. Oh. The bass is live.
Yes.
The bass live too. Okay, come on, my friend. A ver si la podemos aliviar para que se vaya, digo, ya está de muy buen tamaño. Come on, my friend.
Hold it right there.
What?
Hold the fish. Hold
okay.
The fish. Take the plástico. Aquí.
Como no traigo las contrapesos que le ponemos en las aletas de abajo, Steve lo que está haciendo es poner unos jigs de gran tamaño para poder que la lobina se mantenga. Que la lobina se mantenga en esta posición. La razón por la que se mueren en estas situaciones como la que acaban de ver es que la lobina trata de hundirse y se vuelve a regresar por la cantidad de aire que recibe en la vejiga natatoria.
Posible más.
You want to put more?
Sí.
Ok. Entonces, de tanto esfuerzo que hace, la lobina entra en shock y pues se muere, ¿verdad? Pero aquí de esta forma, con esos pesos que estamos poniéndole, lo que pasa es que la lobina se mantiene sola. En el fondo. Yeah, it's better. That's better.
Okay.
Y de esa forma la lobina ya no hace tanto esfuerzo para recuperarse y en unos minutos ya la lobina se empieza a recuperar. Vamos a dejarla un momento ahí con el agua oxigenándola para ver si la podemos rescatar. Vale la pena, es una lobina de muy buen tamaño como para que se muera así nada más. Normalmente en los torneos traemos los productos Sure Life. Y esto nos ayuda a que se recupere más rápido la lobina. En este no era el caso, veníamos nada más a grabar los programas aquí en la presa Comedero. Y eso, pues no pensamos que fuera necesario traer los productos porque agarramos las lobinas y las soltamos inmediatamente para cuidarlas. Pero sí que los invitamos en lo que se recupera la lobina que se queden en esta sección que se llama BDP Kids, cortesía de Pastelería Leti. Acompáñenos.
Yeah, she's good. Good, baby. Come on. Okay, go. Come on. Come on.
GoMB.com.
Adios, amigo. Perfect.
She alive.
Perfect. Yes, after the fish swallow the tilapia and she's almost dead, and what do? We take her, we put her in the live well with a lot of variation, a lot of water, and put some cold water in there, some cold bottles, water bottles. And we have the jigs on her belly, you know, so that she can stay upright. And she settled herself and got rid of the air and the other water that was inside her. And then we turn her loose and she goes down to the cold water. She was only on the surface for maybe 1 hour. And then we left her in there until she settled herself. And then we put her in the water and she goes down. When she gets to the cold water, perfect, perfect. I think that's the best thing, to take care of these fish. They're a valuable resource. So we want to take care of them as best we can, for sure. Better?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Now you're talking. Oh yeah.
Oh, it's a big one. It's a big one.
This is a big one.
Yeah.
Let me get down. Let me get down and help.
Oh, yeah. It's a big one. It's a big fish. Woo!
Oh, yeah.
Oh!
Ay, ay, ay.
Oh, my God. It's another big fish. Woo!
Good job, Edgar.
Thank you, Steve.
Good job. Another good fish.
It's a hard work. Find the good spot.
Yes, but you have to go through, and we have good deep water right here.
Yeah.
You know, no
I
flat.
I can see the hole.
Yeah, no flat. It's very deep.
Very deep.
Oh, man, good hook set.
Wow.
Good job, Edgar.
Thank you, my friend.
Muy bueno. That's beautiful fish, friend.
Hey. Yeah.
Beautiful fish.
Beautiful. Yeah. I'm find the good spot for that.
Okay. Let's let her go.
Okay.
Okay, baby. Time to go home, love. There you go. Huh? Huh?
Oh! Faster. Hey, Steve.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Yes. The Magnum Cutter Worm working good.
Yes, it works good.
I think it's a perfect bait for the Mexican lakes.
It's good for flipping, for casting, for Carolina rig, for total.
Yeah,
it's good.
It's
we catch
good.
A lot of fish and then you catch some good fish.
Yeah. It's a boat situation.
Perfect.
Perfect. Bueno, amigos, ya vieron, estuvimos buscando lobinas. Aquí lo pueden ver en pantalla que estuvimos buscando. Este es un lugar nuevo donde nunca habíamos pescado. Entonces, pues te vas a la prueba y error. Para que no vayan a pensar que nada más es de llegar y mojar anzuelos y agarrar lobinas grandes. Aquí pueden ver la cantidad de impresionante de lobinas pequeñas que sacamos antes de obtener esta captura. Vamos a ver si continuamos sacando más lobinas grandes. Vamos a corte comercial. Regresamos ahorita aquí a
Vámonos de Pesca. Edgar.
Yes, sir.
I think the most important thing, part of our tackle, one of the very most important, is it's the connection between you and that fish, and it's this line.
Yeah, it's the line. I think it's the more delicate
sure.
part of the
It's
tackle.
Delicate for sure. And one of the most important things is once we set the hook on a fish, we want to make sure we can get the fish in the boat.
Yes.
And this line is the Vicious Pro Elite Fluoro, and I'm using 25.
Yeah.
And I'm using 25 for a reason, because we're fishing a lot of heavy brush, rocks, and things like that, and catching, every now and then you're catching really big fish.
Mm-hmm. I can't see that.
Yeah, and this line right here, I've been using this for 3 days. 3 days, and I've only retied twice. I've only had to retry tie twice,
mm-hmm.
because it's very, it goes through the brush and it doesn't scar up real bad. It has less stretch. On the hook set, you get a better hook set with Vicious Pro Elite Fluoro than any other fluoro in the world. It's also the best when it comes to versatility and coming through the brush and not breaking easily. And it lasts a long time. A lot of people think that the line needs to be extremely manageable. Well, I like manageable line for sure. But at the same time, this is a little bit harder to manage, but I promise you, it's worth every penny to use Vicious Pro Elite. And you can clean the line. That's another important thing. People, when you cast a line and it starts getting memory and things like that, the best thing to do is cast out a long distance as far as you can. Take a wet towel or wet hand towel, wet the line right here and spin it up and clean all of the residue off of the line. When you do that, the next cast you make is like brand new line. And so you can use it for a long time. I'll keep it on here for 2 weeks, and I fish every day. And I'll use the same line on here for 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
2 weeks, no problem. If it gets too much memory, too much coiling, all I do, clean the line, and then I stretch. At the camp, I'll just hook the hook over something, and I'll stretch the line, and then reel it back up. It's clean, and then it's just like brand new. So you need to have Vicious Pro Elite Fluoro. It's the best fluoro on the market.
It's a good tip, my friend. Clean the line before the fish.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, you can use it for 2 weeks.
Wow.
No problem. Fill it in.
Yeah.
2 weeks.
It's good. I have 10 years with the same line.
Yeah.
No, it's not good for the industry. Okay. Bueno, vamos a continuar. Vamos a movernos de punto. Move it here.
Huh?
We move it another
yes.
spot. Vamos a movernos de punto. Les pido el favor que continúen con nosotros. Están en Vámonos de Pesca. Acabamos de llegar a otro punto que es un home. Para la raza nueva, un home es una loma hundida. Es un pequeño montículo que hay ahí abajo del agua. Y obviamente es lo que hace el cambio, lo que les explicamos hace rato. Y es donde se concentran las lobinas. Si están grandes o están chicas, bueno, ya depende de muchas cosas. Ahorita estamos viendo o intentando ver si tenemos lobinas de buen tamaño en este home.
Ay, ay, ay.
What happened,
Edgar?
I don't know, it's a strong fish. Look at that. Oh, the hook aren't the troll.
Good hook, huh?
Yeah, very, very nice design of the hook. It's good. Otra buena lobinota de aquí de la presa Comederos. Hey, Steve.
Yeah. Good fish.
It's good fish.
Adios, baby.
It's a bigger fish. Hey, Vigo, we have a couple hours.
Yeah.
But I feel good because rest well.
Yes.
Did you rest well?
Oh, yeah, I rest very well.
Yeah, you can see the in the screen, the new rebuilding.
Yeah, the new, All of the lodge, he's totally rebuilt the lodge, and it's beautiful. All the air conditioners in the rooms are remote control.
Makes
it very cold and very nice, very comfortable.
The shower is hot.
Oh, yeah.
The shower is hot.
Oh, it's big showers, too.
Yeah.
Very big showers.
More bathroom in each.
There's three bathrooms in each one of the houses, one of the houses.
It's very comfortable
there. Oh, yeah, it's great, for sure.
No make a line in the morning.
No line. That's right, no lines in the morning for the bathroom.
Yeah.
And, you know, the comfort and the service that Ron Speed gives is second to none. It's the best that there is. The food is great. The service is great. The guides are great. The fact is anyone, amateurs can come. You don't have to be professional to catch big fish on Comodoro. The guides are very well trained. They know the water. They're very professional. They help everyone find. They already know where the fish are. They help everyone to learn to catch fish. So it's a perfect situation.
Yeah.
Perfect situation.
How about the boats?
Well, the boats are the best.
I can see they have a big trolling motor.
Yes.
80 pounders.
That's right. 80 pound thrust. And we've got Mercury electric start motors. And you've got sonars at the console. You got sonars in the front.
Yeah.
And pedestal seats. You got everything you want. It's very comfortable.
This kind of things make a difference.
Sure, it's a difference. It's professional.
Yeah.
This is the most professional outfit that there is in all of Mexico.
Okay.
All of Mexico.
Entonces, no dudes ni en contactar a Ron Speed Junior Adventures. Ya tenemos WhatsApp para que inmediatamente te comuniques y cheques si hay disponibilidad. Aquí en Comederos, puede ser en El Salto, en Picacho,
Salto.
Tenemos ahí servicio en estas tres presas que son la verdad de una maravilla para la gente amante de este tipo de actividad que es la pesca de lobina. Yo creo que no vas a encontrar una presa como Comederos, una presa como El Salto, una presa como Picachos para venir a pasar un fin de semana que va a ser la aventura de tu vida. That's right.
Comprendo un poquito.
Muy bien. Vamos, continuamos con el programa. Vamos a ver si enganchamos otra buena lobina aquí en Vámonos de Pesca. Hey, Bigo.
Yeah.
It's time to launch.
Okay.
Yeah, we have a perfect fishing day. Just half
this
day.
This morning was good, yeah.
Half day. Because the personnel in Ron Speed Junior Adventures waiting for us for lunch. What do
no
you
problem.
Think about it?
Yeah, let's go. And we come back this evening and it's fish some more?
Okay. No, no. The evening.
Yeah.
The evening.
Okay.
Yeah. We were in the wind.
Yeah.
I think the wind is perfect for
a little bait. Little wind, and we'll throw spinner baits this evening.
Yeah.
Want to?
Uh-huh. Big spinner bait,
big bass.
Okay.
I guarantee big bass
hope
on Comodoro.
So. Yeah. Okay, Steve, it's an honor for us that you've been in Vámonos de Pesca. And hope the evening we'll catch a big fish.
I think for sure, at Comodoro with Ron Speed Jr., we're going to catch big fish.
Okay.
In the evening, when the wind is blowing, even in this hot weather, no problem with big spinner baits. You can catch the gun.
I hope so. Yeah. I'm shaking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, just wait for a little while. And Edgar, thank you. You're one of my very best friends, for sure. You're one of the best. You've got the best pro staff in all of Mexico, for sure. And I appreciate just being helping you and being a part of it.
Thank you, Steve.
Thank you, Edgar.
Okay, amigos. Bueno, esperando que el programa ha sido de su agrado. Ahí están unos nuevos tips. Vienen estos nuevos productos que son las Magnum Cutel Worms, que estarán pronto disponibles en Bazar y con todos nuestros distribuidores en México. Y esperemos que la próxima jornada de pesca, que va a ser hoy en la tarde, sea muy productivo porque esperamos mucho viento del norte y según Steve dice que haciendo aire aquí el spinner bait de Oldham Lures, la medida grande de una onza funciona perfectamente bien, así que no te pierdas un episodio más aquí en Vámonos de Pesca.